What is happening, guys? Welcome to the vlog. Just finished up training for today. Today we're talking about food prep and when you go out for food, how to change your diet up and making sure you can still stick to it no matter what. So we're gonna go to, just take a guess. I'm with Tiago, take a guess where we're going. Seven Ribs.
Fries or mafi fries?
Are you fat? Fries. Are you feeling fat today?
The machine proved that I am
skinnier
than, you. No, not skinnier, leaner.
Leaner.
Yes.
You're definitely not leaner.
Yeah, I am. The machine is never lying.
First thing you need to do is make sure you make good decisions when going out with friends. So Tiago's good decision is fries or no fries?
No fries.
I'm like everyone else. I'm a bit of a FOMO, a bit of a FOMO, fear of missing out. So make sure you make good decisions when you're going out with friends for good food. Then when we go back later, we're gonna food prep. So just trying to make sure you're sticking to good food, eating well, and you can still enjoy life at the same time. Something that Sully said in the last video. This is good. If you've not been here, you're stupid. So as much as I wanted brisket sandwich and as much as I wanted the ribs, they were our ribs, but as much as I wanted the brisket sandwich, I chose not to. Salad, mashed potato and chunk ribs. So all about when you go out for food, if you go into nice places, try and make sure you make good decisions on trying to make sure it's as healthy as possible, because you can still enjoy the company when it's good. And making sure that you're enjoying yourself at the same time, but still eating decently healthy. So I'm gonna enjoy this. This is a workout I want you guys to try that I did today. And then after, less food prep for the week, and I'm gonna give you some nice tips to make it high fat or high carbs. Workout, try it out. It was fucking horrible. Today we're doing two dishes, one chicken, one beef. I'll be honest with you, I have been slacking with my food prep. I used to food prep all the time, and then I'll be honest, it's really fucking easy to go out and eat for dinner, as you just saw. Do you know what is essential for cooking? Chins. You gotta have chins. I'll be honest with you guys, these meals normally take, usually, prep 15 minutes. To ignore, you take me for a boo. You take me for a boo. I never knew anybody till I knew you. And we're done. Damn, that looks good. Time to Tupperware this bad boy up. Now, it's time for the taste test. look. Whoo! In each one, I split the chicken up into three meals, so it will have about 350 grams total. 200 grams of chicken cooked, then about a tablespoon of peanut butter, and then the spinach. Not too dry, not too liquidy. I sound like one of those people on TV where it's like, do you know what, Sharon? I feel like the texture of this chicken is outstanding. No, but I actually think it's pretty decent. The beef. This is gonna be my dinner for the next 5 days. I'm probably gonna have this with some wraps or some rice. It's not bad, not bad. What I would probably add, which I didn't actually have, is balsamic vinegar. That would give it a fucking good kick. Like, if you like ketchup, probably add more ketchup, but I didn't want to have too much of shitty food in there. It was just a little bit tasty. Peter, do you know what? This is average. It's pretty tasty, but it doesn't have that kick that that peanut butter chicken had that Sharon made. I even got it fucked up. Fuck. Anyway, nutritional value now. I'm going to talk about macros, all the macronutrients involved and what the calories will be overall, because that's what it's all about when we're trying to lose weight or gain weight. Using my fitness pal and the ingredients I use and trying to go off a rough guide splitting it evenly, this is what we got. So from looking at the nutritional value of just the chicken, peanut butter, and the spinach, taking into account you can use any peanut butter you want, it is only 386 calories, which is barely anything. I am then gonna add 350 grams of potatoes. This makes it a 780 calorie meal. Let's say 800 calories. This is an 800 calorie meal where the primary source is fat. I'm gonna add in three medium sized tortilla wraps. They're very medium slash small size. And that's gonna make it 1,100 calories and make it of a carb focused meal. The beef alone without the potatoes is 369 calories. With the potatoes, once again, it is 750 calories. So, these are just some nice, easy meals which are good balance, which are gonna be healthy for you, and they're gonna be very tasty. So it's a good balance of both. They are not the most strictest of meals. We wanna make sure it's tasty, enjoyable, even though they're basically the same thing, but we wanna make sure that we wanna eat it continuously, because that means we're actually gonna enjoy what we eat rather than being planned and boring. Let's ask someone who I know would not eat healthy food unless it tasted good what they think. Wait, it's in the building.
What up?
So, we got peanut butter chicken.
Yep.
You
see, and with you see, there is vegetables, and I'm not a vegetable fan. So, but Stumpy cook it.
Yeah. Let's see. All right. Peanut butter chicken. Try it.
I make my water in case something happens.
Peanut butter chicken, healthy dish. Witness. Let me know what you think. Don't eat the potatoes, because the potatoes are not the best. Potatoes are average. Peanut butter chicken with spinach. He doesn't like vegetables. Honest thoughts.
This is like hummus.
No, it's peanut butter.
I'll do a deal, okay? I'll pay you. I'll pay you every day to cook for me. Just the chicken, just the chicken.
How much you want to pay me, honey? You like the chicken?
Yeah, I love the chicken. Above that, I don't know. I just want a chicken.
Man, don't eat
amazing.
Too much. Don't eat too much. That's my lunch. Like,
it's balila. You know balila?
No. So guys, even if you don't like veg, you can cook good food which has vegetables in and trick people, i.e. fitness, to eat food with even one vegetable in, and he'll still enjoy it.
It tastes like balila. People will, you know what is balila? You know hummus before they cook it?
Yeah.
It's balila. It's called balila. It tastes like that. No one will believe me, but it tastes like that.
I'm that good. And you guys can see it's really super simple.
Good, it's good. I love it.
You're just gonna carry on eating my lunch
now? No.
If fitness can like it, then you can. Just saying. With Ramadan coming around the corner, this is the perfect time to food prep your meals, getting yourself ready, and making sure that you eat healthy throughout the month. Because I know it's my third year in Saudi Arabia. You need to make sure you prep your meals here. Otherwise, you're gonna end up eating shit whilst you're here and during that month. So this is why it's essential to make sure you eat good. And I know we go out for food all the time, and it is so easy to get fat here in Saudi, which is why we need to make sure that we make smart decisions on eating healthy and making sure that you don't eat shit and you enjoy your life at the same time. Yes, guys, I hope you've liked the video. In the next video, I'll be talking about training during Ramadan, eating, when to eat, what will be best for you, good decisions, and talking about, obviously, fasting in general, not just fasting during Ramadan. Do I like it? What's the best way for you to do it? And the best way to do it when you do it during Ramadan, and just talking about it in general, the overall experience. So, hope you like the video. Smash that like button if it's helped you out. Guys, subscribe. Until next time, peace.